Why am I always so tired? The science and what you can do about it. Fortunately, you don't have to be tired and fatigued all the time. In fact, optimal energy is easily within your grasp. In this video, I'm going to share the real reason you feel tired so often, and I'll let you know exactly what you can do to turn it around. You'll feel refreshed, rejuvenated, and renewed. And you'll enjoy boundless energy to do all the things you want to do. Today, we'll zoom in on the root of your tiredness, the number one culprit of the fatigue that prevents you from living the fully energized life you want. Look, I know there's much you want to accomplish in life, don't we all? But you just can't seem to get your energy levels up, right? The coffee doesn't help, the energy drinks don't help. From the time you wake up in the morning to the time you return to bed at night, you're plagued by constant tiredness and you can't seem to get anything done. By now, you've probably watched a lot of videos and looked everywhere for an answer to your problems. Alas, nothing seems to work. Some things might have helped a little for a short while, but you always ended up in the same spot. Well, I'm going to tell you why. It's because you aren't focusing on the root cause. You focused only on treating the symptoms or fixing small issues here and there. But what you really need to do is look at the bigger picture. Ready to do that now? The science of energy production. What's behind your lack of energy? The answer is simple. Your body isn't producing enough of it. Makes sense, right? If your body is inefficient at producing energy, your energy levels will be low. So how does your body create energy? Let's discuss some simple biology. Many of your body's cells contain little organs called mitochondria, and they're responsible for producing energy. In biology class, you might have learned of them as the cell's powerhouse. And this is key, because it's precisely why we should focus on the health of our mitochondria. If we want to improve energy levels, we must address the root of the problem. And the root of the problem is often just that, our mitochondria. Mitochondria are critical to health. They make energy, but also serve other critical functions like regulating cell growth. So of course, this only adds to the importance of keeping your mitochondria in tip-top shape. But let's get back to the topic at hand, energy. So as you may remember from biology class, mitochondria make energy in the form of ATP. ATP, remember what that is. It stands for adenosine triphosphate, and it's the primary energy carrier in all living organisms. For you, this means that whatever food you eat gets broken down into ATP, which your cells then use for energy. So ATP is basically your body's main energy source. Mitochondrial dysfunction. All right, so what happens if your mitochondria don't function properly? All sorts of crap. Poorly performing mitochondria have been linked to numerous diseases. These are just a few of them. Mitochondrial dysfunction also leads to increased production of something called reactive oxygen species, or ROS for short. ROSs wreak even more havoc on your body and could cause a slew of other diseases, including even cancer. Yes, I know this video is supposed to be about fatigue, not diseases. I don't mean to scare you, but I just want to emphasize how critical mitochondrial health is. But let's get back on track. So mitochondrial dysfunction has also been linked to excessive fatigue, which makes sense, as mitochondria produce most of our energy. And if you're always tired, does that necessarily mean your mitochondria are dysfunctional? And if so, what diseases might you be predisposed to acquiring in the future? You might think there's nothing to worry about because it's unlikely that you have mitochondrial dysfunction in the first place. And to be fair, that might be true, but it's still possible that you have it, and mitochondrial dysfunction is a lot more widespread than you might think. How widespread is it? How widespread is mitochondrial dysfunction? According to the Heart MD Institute, more than 50 million people in the US are thought to be affected by conditions involving mitochondrial dysfunction. Furthermore, a 2007 article published in the Annals of Neurology confirmed that mitochondrial DNA diseases are a common cause of chronic disease and are more prevalent than previously believed. So, it seems like for many of us, mitochondrial dysfunction is a very real possibility indeed. I'm convinced that it plays a central role in most of our fatigue problems and chronic illnesses. I mean, just look at the organs that have the most mitochondria: the brain, the eyes, and the heart. Think about it. These are the places most affected when we're tired. We can't think properly, our eyes get tired, and we get out of breath super easily. I don't think this is a coincidence. Do you? So as you can see, living with mitochondrial dysfunction isn't any way to live. You will feel fatigued, be at risk for a slew of diseases, and most likely feel like your life has been sucked out of you. But not all hope is lost. You just need to address the problem and take steps to improve mitochondrial health. You can definitely heal your mitochondria and regain your vitality. New mitochondria grow and die rapidly, so your energy levels can't be transformed, and you can't feel like a new person in just a matter of weeks. Yes, just weeks, and you'll feel fresh and ready to take on the world. So what can be done? Thankfully, if you're experiencing mitochondrial dysfunction, not all hope is lost. Several studies show evidence that certain supplements and lifestyle changes can significantly increase mitochondrial function and significantly decrease fatigue. Let me quote this excerpt from one study. Clinical trials have shown the utility of using oral replacement supplements such as L-carnitine, alpha-lipoic acid, coenzyme Q10, reduced nicotinamide, adenosine dinucleotide, membrane phospholipase, and other supplements. Combinations of these supplements can reduce significantly the fatigue and other symptoms associated with chronic disease and can naturally restore mitochondrial function, even in long-term patients with intractable fatigue. I'll emphasize one phrase here. Even in long-term patients with intractable fatigue. So it's not too late for anyone. Everyone has the power to heal their mitochondria. So please, if you have friends or family members who might be suffering from mitochondrial dysfunction, please share this video with them. This is important information that most people are not aware of. And supplements aren't the only thing that can help your mitochondria. They're also profoundly affected by air quality, sleep, nutrition, and many other factors. And you can learn more about these in our Ultimate Energy Crash Course. You can get your free copy at activatedbody.com. You'll get a copy of our actual proprietary energy blueprint, as well as specific action steps to maximize energy and improve mitochondrial health. This will allow you to start rebuilding new and better mitochondria, as well as take better care of and rejuvenate the precious ones you already have. Again, visit activatedbody.com, and you can also find the link right below this video. So, as you can see, your mitochondrial function can be restored to its former glory, and it can't even be better than it used to be. You'd feel more energized than ever before, and you'd regain your vitality and your health. But that's not all. Through the process of mitochondrial biogenesis, you can actually grow even more mitochondria and produce even more energy. You can even increase the rate of mitochondrial biogenesis by incorporating certain things into your life. I'll be talking about some of these things in upcoming videos. So make sure you also subscribe to my channel here on YouTube to get notified instantly when I release new videos. Just imagine having more mitochondria than ever before and having them all performing magnitudes better than ever before. You will be bursting with energy. It seems like instead of treating the symptoms of diseases and problems linked to mitochondrial dysfunction, we should instead work on the root cause of the problem by fixing the mitochondrial dysfunction itself. By changing our way of life, we can make our mitochondria not only survive, but also thrive. Feeling horrible, living with constant fatigue, experiencing brain fog, these aren't things you should have to deal with. So start addressing your problems before you become too sick, because honestly, you'll become sick over time. Take back control of your mitochondria. Take back control of your energy. And most important of all, take back control of your life. Essential health checkup. Before you go, I just want to quickly talk about one more thing. Even if you have no problems with energy and you're completely healthy, I'll still recommend that everyone should get a full health checkup. Get your thyroid levels checked. Thyroid function is a serious problem that affects a lot of people all over the world, and it's something you should take seriously. Get a full food allergy blood panel. Foods you regularly eat might be toxic to your body and thus your mitochondria. Also get your hormones levels checked and get your blood tested for nutrient deficiencies. And also get your inflammation levels checked. CRP, LPPLA2, and homocysteine are all good markers for inflammation. Even if you turn out to be completely healthy, at least you'll still have gained extremely valuable data on your health. It can show you what you're doing wrong and what you can improve on in the future. I'll talk about topics for which you can use this data in coming videos, ultimately for the purpose of increasing your energy, motivation, health, and happiness even further. Now, before closing, I'd like to again invite you to go through our free energy crash course. This is available at activatedbody.com. It will really, really help you. There, you can grab your free body off again, the ultimate energy crash course. In there, you'll learn powerful tricks to skyrocket your energy levels and improve your mitochondrial health. Again, that's activatedbody.com, and you can also find the link in the description below this video. So that's it for today. If you like this video and you want to know more about what you can do to heal your mitochondria, or if you just want to, want more information about how to optimize your biology and how you can activate your potential, hit that subscribe button. And if you want to get notified when I upload new videos, hit that little bell icon next to the subscribe button. I'm super excited to be on this journey with you, and I really look forward to seeing you again. Let me know in the comments what you want to see next. Always remember, you have all the control. You can fix your problems, and you have the power. Make sure you use it.